Hello, my dear viewers. It's me, Siri Berlin. I'm an artist and coach from Berlin. It's 2 p.m. sharp and I'm live with today's topic, inspiration. And I'm wondering, how inspired are you today? Are you inspired? Are you online? Could you say hello if you are? That would be fantastic. I prepared a little bit in the last 2 hours what I want to talk about today, and a funny experience. I did all my vlogs recently without preparation and I wasn't nervous at all, but today I'm kind of nervous because I have to transmit all this content and I want you to think that's a really good thing. Oh, somebody's watching. Hello, who are you? Can you send me a hello or something so I know who's watching? That would be super nice. Oh, it's Christian. Hey, Christian, are you sitting next door? That's super sweet. Okay, maybe somebody else is joining. So today it's all about inspiration, and I started posting on my Facebook page the quote from Picasso: inspiration exists, but it has to find us working. And I wanted to know whether you think this is true. On the one hand, I think, of course, it's really good to have some work you do all the time. It makes me nervous that somebody is online watching. So funny. Maybe you could come inside so I can see you and talk to you personally. I don't know. Leave it in the comment whether you find you have to work all the time to be inspired. That's what many people say. So some artists build up routines and some don't, so I'm not sure. Sometimes I try to get a routine and sometimes I just try to be myself, which is more kind of a chaotic person. I promised to explain you how I inspire myself or how I find inspiration. Before that, I want to talk about what actually is inspiration, because we use this word quite oftenly. Oh, this person is so inspired. And if you want, I could send you a PDF with all my videos which I find inspirational and all the tools I use to be inspired. Send me an email to siri@siriberlin.de and I send you the PDF, and you can tell me whether you liked what I wrote you. The word inspiration is from Latin, and it's translated from the Latin inspirare, to breathe into. So you have some kind of divine breath into you if you're inspired, or divine sparkle. And when we think about inspiration, we also think about muses, people who inspire us. Or you think about these painters who had their mainly feminine muses with masculine painters. And I think this is really, really interesting to look at, because people actually inspire me most. I'm painting a lot because I met someone who really, really inspired me. Could also be a god, could also be a Holy Spirit, but then what do you do if you're not spiritual or not religious at all? Can't you be inspired then? I don't believe that. So I think you should just trust yourself and trust your inspiration. And I believe that this comes for everyone if you really trust yourself and if you open up to what you can receive from the outer world and also from the inner world. So I divide things or people which inspire me from the outside, and I inspire myself also from the inside. And one thing is, for example, I did last year a one drawing a day. That was kind of a routine. I thought about how can I stay creative when I have to work so much and I didn't have so much time to be creative, to do my things. And I, of course, was distracted by my bread job. And this little exercise, like 15 to 20 minutes every day, keep drawing, inspired me really. And some of the drawings I did in my daily routine, one drawing a day, turned into a picture. So my Wolkenwanderer, the Cloud Wanderer, for example, is inspired by one of my one drawings. So I think it's interesting when you are open and look at what you're doing, or you look at what you receive from the outer world, then you can receive and produce something creative out of that. What else? I recommend, and I recommend it today already, that do what you love first. Don't start with something boring. Don't start with learning a new program or learning a new technique. Start with something which really opens your heart, which gets your juices flowing. Because I think this energy also lets you do new techniques or new programs, or lets you do also texts and stuff, you know, things which are really boring. At least for me, text is really boring. I'm not sure, maybe there are some text enthusiasts. You should tell me and maybe do my text then. That would be really nice. So I think love before duty. At some point, I quit my job at a big company where I was doing a well-paid job. But I thought I really need to do my art, and this was more important for me. And I got a nice little card from a friend there, and it was saying, the dishwashing can wait, life can't. So, and this is really, really important for me. And I had it on my entrance door for a long time. So I remember and remind myself that my art, for example, is more important than being super secure and having a fixed job or something. So I would claim what you love first, and then afterwards, when you nourish your creative inside person, then you can do, yeah, then you can go to your duties if you want. Of course, you have to do them at some point. That's why they're called duties, but I think it's a better energy if you do something nice first. And then what I do to become inspired, if I'm stuck, like I don't know what to do, normally I don't procrastinate. I'm most of the time have too many ideas at the same time. Oh, somebody else is watching. Hello. Send me a heart or send me something so I know that you're here. That's so nice to see. Oh, already gone. Okay. So it was like, what do I do to, when I'm stuck, when I don't know what to do. I have many ideas, and a friend who's also a coach gave me a big glass of a big jar of marbles, and they stand for all my ideas I have in my head. And sometimes I'm trapped and don't know what idea to pick, so I don't know whether I want to write a song, play guitar, paint a picture, write something. And then I take just one of these marbles and go for a walk. Going for a walk is also a really good idea to become inspired. And this does help me to have a decision where I can then focus on one thing from my maybe five things I really like to do. I limit it down to just one thing which I can do at the time. So I change the topic maybe, or I change the location and go to a cafe. Writing, for example, I do mainly at cafes, and I like the business there, as I said yesterday in my video from Lux, my favorite waffle place. I keep saying that. I think I should at some point get waffles for free. So that's for me really important. And as I said, going for walks. Some time ago, I think it's more than a year, I visited a friend at Ammersee. It's close to Munich. And we met there for Creative Week. I think this is also really nice to meet other artists to inspire you, like to inspire yourself with the other person. And I was so stuck. Still, my friend was there. She was doing her work, and I couldn't do anything. But I planned to be so productive in this week, and I just was stuck. And a friend then told me that he's going on walks when he's stuck. So he has a certain pace when he goes for walks. He doesn't go into really crowded areas. So he has a specific way of walking to get his inspiration going. And I thought, okay, when he says it, then it must be true. And I try it, but I don't believe it. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. So I went out, crying because I was so sad that I didn't produce. But I went and I thought, okay, I'll find it. It must be somewhere. And at some point, luckily I had some tiny little sheet of paper with me and a tiny, tiny pen. I sat down at the lake and wrote a song, which is one of my favorite self-written songs these days. So I think going for walks sometimes seems suspicious is really, really a good idea to be inspired. This is for music writing. What do I do else? When I have no idea about how I paint or what I paint, then I start by preparing, like preparing my studio, preparing colors and pencils. I always say pencils, brushes. This is the Swedish word for pinsel, is pencil. So you know this now as well. Christian, you should applause now. For me, like feeling the paint, seeing the paint, how it is on the background really inspires me. And many of my pictures are really inspired, I would say, cloud watching. So I watch the background for a long time, and at some point a picture appears. So I'm not planning I'm going to paint this or that. I just trust that it's already there on the background and that it will talk to me. It's really like watching clouds in summer. And if you, in your spare time, because creativity needs a lot of time, where you don't do anything, where you are free and where you just can go for walks or be yourself or breathe or really feel yourself, then you can just start, oh, Luisa, a heart, thank you so much. Nice to see you. We're talking about inspiration, and I just was talking about what I do when I'm not so inspired. So I see like cloud watching in my pictures. For example, the picture just behind me also worked that way. It's like staring into the sky, looking into the clouds, and make up what kind of figures are going on there. So I really, really like that. And now I have two people online and I'm super scared that I'm not good enough. That should be a different talk. Okay. Another thing I find really important is to make art, to make your work into a play again. Because I believe that the creative part of us, like our visitor from Sunday also said, is the inner child. Become your childish self again. Spoil your inner child, your inner artist child. What does he or she want to do? What does he or she need to feel good? What kind of surroundings? Me, for example, I need a colorful surrounding, so I have most of my pictures standing around. It's kind of chaotic most of the time. And sometimes I buy myself something playful, like I got a really nice present, which is super playful, so really inspiring, I think. So really being my child self and spoil it, this inspires me a lot. Sometimes when I work, I feel that I want to do more and more and more, and I don't stop. And then after I did that, I feel dried out, so I don't have the chance to go on. And this also I find really, really important. Yeah, it's little, the Luisa just wrote, the mug is really cool. It's the tiny tree from a Marvel movie. I love him. I'm Groot. Okay, back to inspiration. You see, I'm super inspired by Groot. Make your art, make your work, if you're not an artist, make your work into a play. Spoil your child self. I think you can really, really take something out of that. All the things you were never allowed to do when you were a child, just try them. You're grown up now, you deserve it. Okay, what else do I have? I already said spoil your inner artist child, because I believe it's the source. Is the source of your creativity. And then something what is really, really hard for me is take time off. In my agile artist board, which I showed you in a different video, I put in 2 times 5 hours of not doing anything. That's really, really hard for me. Hello, a third person is watching, I'm so happy. Send me a heart or a like, then I know who you are. So don't overload your schedule. We're living in a busy time. Everybody keeps saying that, but it's so true. If we're waiting somewhere, we're looking at our phone. If we're, I don't know, want to start working and we want to research something in the internet, then we get stuck on Facebook or get stuck in our research. So try to take time off, not especially off the internet. Doesn't necessarily mean that the internet is bad or you shouldn't watch it. I watch videos a lot. It's another source of inspiration for me to watch other artists while they produce their work. There's so many nice things. As I said in the beginning of this video, I'm preparing a little PDF which you can have if you send me an email to siriberlin@siriberlin.de. I'll write this down in the comments and then you get the PDF with all my ideas about inspiration and some inspirational videos as well from other people, not from me. I hope this inspires you as well, by the way. Yeah, I really like one quote. I forgot from who it is. It's about that you, for being creative, you need an obscene amount of time, which is free, which is just for you, which is not dedicated to dishwashing, which is not dedicated to preparing. So just spoil yourself, take your time, don't overload your schedule. My hardest task, but I try to do it a bit more. And then, you won't imagine it, sleep. Sometimes when I'm in one topic, for example, my tax, or I just sent out an offer for my bread job, then I can't find back to being creative. I still can remember what I wanted to do, but I feel so worn out. And then for me, sleep is really good. And a friend I worked with for a long time, now we have 5 visitors watching, sent me a hello. I'm so happy. That's fun. And more exciting for me. So now I get really, really excited and scared. But sleep is really good. To come from one topic to the other. So a composer I worked with for some time, he always said, I can sleep just like this. I trained it to change the topic, to change from composing to studying something else like playing piano or whatever. I can't really remember what he did, but this also works for me, that I just go to bed even though I'm not tired, just rest for 15 minutes or half an hour, and then come back to a different topic, because we're so overloaded with all the input, not just from, you know, from our surroundings, from TV, from internet, from phones, from, we need to talk to people. We're not used anymore to idleness, to not do anything, to watch the clouds. I highly recommend watching clouds. I got this idea from someone else. I really have stopped since I was a child to watch clouds. That's, for me, one of the precious things I learned, to really take my time, maybe sleep some. Okay, what is else interesting for me? Morning pages. Morning pages also inspire me. Morning pages are a practice where you empty out your head in the morning so you can start your day freshly. Unfortunately, we have funny thoughts when we wake up sometimes. And of course, one can do it whenever in the day, but I find it's really important that it's in the morning. I can also ask my artist child what he or she wants to do during the day, what's good for her. It's a good practice to silence the inner critique, and I have some really good ideas while writing morning pages. So this I can really highly recommend as well. If you have questions to morning pages, write it down in the comments and I will answer all your questions, of course. Another way of being inspired is going to exhibitions, for example, going to concerts, meet other artists. For example, I went with my partner to an exhibition from Egon Schiele in Vienna. That so much inspired me. And what it always does, going to other exhibitions, is I don't feel so small anymore, because you see that also these big artists have some really crappy drawings, and they just, you know, the curators just put it up because this famous person made it. And you can steal techniques. Like in life drawing class, I just stole, Chile put really often some white around his figures. And I just stole it and it made my drawing look so cool. I felt it was kind of cheating, but I love it. It's you might have seen it in my posts. It's so cool, it's just a trick. And I got the inspiration from Egon Schiele, and thank you so much for that. And you can do that with other artists as well. Our nice friend who visited us on Sunday, also an artist, she goes to life drawings 4 or 5 times a week, and that's also a big inspiration that you see that also someone else is really dedicating her time towards art. And you get all these nice ideas, you know, what other people think. About like what materials they use, how they deal with situations, like am I allowed to go out with my art or not? Is that possible? Or do you also feel kind of stuck sometimes with your inspiration? So I really, really recommend meeting other artists. Even though if you're shy, there's so many shy artists out there which like to meet. Maybe it's a quiet meeting then. With me, it's probably not so quiet, but I think it's a good way of indulging yourself. And I think all our artist children feel so connected and they really want to see each other. And it's also a good way of staying inspired or becoming inspired. Yeah. And as I said in the beginning, have a break before you're completely empty. All this somehow leads to my coaching self. My coaching self says, what you need for being inspired actually is to know, who am I? What do I need? And how do I get there? So all these things I mentioned are kind of a path to find out more about yourself, more about your true wishes, your true needs. And if you know that, it's much easier to follow your path being an artist. Of course, this also applies to other jobs, but as I'm doing this arts vlog, I'm talking about arts a lot. But of course, you can also have the PDF, which I prepare for your own inspiration in every job you like. And these three questions actually are the basic questions, like who am I, what do I need, and how do I get there, are the basic questions of becoming resilient, of not burning out, of being able to deal with change. And as artists, we deal a lot with change because we have not so much a routine, and then we have money because somebody bought something or paid us for something we did, and then there is a big period of nothing, or also feeling super inspired, putting everything into one work, and then having a hard time after we handed in this thing and there is nothing. There's just a blank for a week or so. This is really hard. And I think also for these kind of hard times, it's really good to strengthen yourself, to reflect what makes you strong, what makes you resilient, what keeps you going. So I would say it's like, what kind of surroundings do I need? What kind of clothes do I like? What kind of food makes me happy? I know someone who's watching who is into raw food, and she really says that's doing a lot for her. It's really important to feel good, to have a special diet. Just look into it. What is your need? What do you really need? And I think this will lead to good inspiration. So what do you think? Have you more ideas, the people who are watching? What's good for inspiration? You can write it down if you want. I'm really inspired by people who are watching me, even though it makes me more shy and excited. I hope you could take something out of it. As I said, I prepare a little PDF. Write down in the comments or send me an email to ziri@ziriberlin.de, and I sent you the PDF with all my types of getting inspired and some other nice things. I hope you have a nice day. See you tomorrow. Write down in the comments if you missed something, if you have different ideas of becoming inspired. What is your favorite way of becoming inspired? And I hope I see you tomorrow. Hey, doh.